President Joe Biden's ambitious plan to vaccinate at least 150 million Americans in his first 100 days just got a boost. On Thursday, another vaccine maker has filed for emergency use authorization. Johnson & Johnson has asked U.S. regulators to approve the world's first single-dose COVID-19 vaccine. Based on preliminary results from a massive international study, Johnson & Johnson's vaccine has a 66% success rate in protecting people against moderate to severe COVID-19. The U.S. has agreed to pay $1 billion for 100 million doses of Johnson & Johnson's vaccine for the first half of the year. The data may seem concerning, though, in terms of lower efficacy, especially against new variants. But the country's top infectious disease expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci, still feels hopeful.
The good news is that when you looked across all of the countries, the protection against truly severe disease was well over 80%. In fact, about 88.8%. Also of interest is that in the South African study, as well as all of the others, there were essentially no hospitalizations or deaths. So the sobering news is that we are dealing with variants, antigenic variation, which does have clinical consequences, as I mentioned on the last press briefing, of escape from some of the monoclonal antibody protection and a diminution in some of the protection that we have from the current vaccines. But the somewhat encouraging news is the rather complete protection against very severe disease, including hospitalizations and deaths.
Meanwhile, on Friday, the Biden administration announced it will ramp up manufacturing of Pfizer and BioNTech's vaccine, as well as the availability of at-home COVID tests through the enactment of the Defense Production Act, or DPA.
The country is well behind where we need to be in testing, particularly the rapid at-home tests that will allow us all to get back to normal activities like work and school. Over the coming weeks, the U.S. government has plans to invest in another 6 suppliers to rapidly surge domestic testing capability. And thanks to this action, 61 million point-of-care or at-home tests will be available by the end of this summer.
The DPA in action will likewise increase the supply of key medical products such as gauze and medical gloves. The Pentagon has also approved the deployment of 1,100 active duty troops to help deliver COVID-19 vaccine shots to different parts of the U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin is sending the first batch of troops to vaccination sites in California. The latest data from the Johns Hopkins University shows that the U.S. has reported more than 26.7 million COVID-19 cases, with over 122,000 new infections in the last 24 hours alone, as well as close to 457,000 deaths since the start of the pandemic.